is Sherry. I'm at WonderCon 2023, and I'm talking to AJ about nanotech. So what's going on, AJ? Because you have a good-sized booth full of lots of fun toys for us nerds.
We do. We have tons. We've got, like, this big, giant section here at WonderCon, and, boy, we're right out in front of the Tamashii Nations one, so this is, like, the high collectible action figures. You know, we also have stuff like statues with this brand too, but there's so many. In fact, this is the ones with some of the con exclusives. So, you know, we've got these two One Piece exclusives. Actually, like the Luffy had sold out, and like people are like, you know how it gets when people, like it's sold out, it's for the day. I'm like, I'm sorry, it's for, you know, it's show. But you know what, we still got a great other exclusive for One Piece, as well as an Ultraman figure, and I believe we have a Gundam one as well. So like fans are always just lining up for exclusives. Like every time we have event exclusives, it is like, you know, Lion City.
And when you guys say exclusive, you mean exclusive, so you have to come to the con.
Yeah, exactly. They're event exclusives, so, like, you know, the only place to get them are during events where we're here. You know, like, you could be at another show, but we're not there. You know, that's not going to be there. Only the ones we're present at.
Oh, my gosh. Well, that is another reason you have to buy con tickets to attend stuff. And can you tell me about a couple of these fan exclusives that we have right here behind us?
Oh, yeah, of course. So this one's Demon Slayer, and these don't move. These aren't articulate. In fact, that's what the zero stands for, the figure at zero. But they're sculpted so beautifully, and they're in their, you know, an iconic pose that people remember, whether it was one of their attacks or just like a moment in the anime itself. You know, they've got translucent pieces, and again, with the details on there, with the hair, the effects, that it's just something that, you know, makes a great piece for your collection, whether you want it in box or out of box.
So one of the things that I'm always curious about as a fan, how do you guys select the images that you are going to be making the collectibles from, and how closely do you work with the artists?
So with brand, I believe they work pretty close with, you know, the IP and the licensors for that. You know, I'm sure they definitely give a little bit of what they'd like to see, but I think when it comes down to it, just has to be a moment that everyone kind of remembers. You know, that's kind of how I want my figures as well. Like, it's like I would like it posed exactly from something of a memorable moment. So I think that's exactly how these all are. Like the first time he used like his flame, or like Inosuke with his blade, you know, they're exactly the point of the anime where I'm like, oh yeah, like that makes me feel with joy and giddy.
Now when you're here, sometimes you'll have the normal collectibles that you can buy, then you have these giant collectibles. Do you ever sell the giant collectible?
So many people ask about, like, how can I get one of those? Unfortunately, we don't sell them. They are great to take photos with, and also take as many photos as you want with them, but we don't sell them. It would be cool, though, right? Yeah, I'm sure there's plenty of people. We'll just get, like, a count, you know, we'll get a raise of hands who'd like one of these in their home.
So you guys get to take them home, and we don't.
They go back in their little box. They go wait until the next con, so.
Now, do I feel like an Ocean 11 experience coming on with someone going to your store and grabbing a couple?
There's a lot of people who would be like, oh, I'd love to get my hands on it. So where exactly is it? I'm like, I gotta think about that.
Yeah, they're trying to get me on. Like, now, let's see a couple of the other collectible items that you guys have that are not just exclusives here for WonderCon, but for people who want to order online or might be looking forward to the next convention that you'll be attending.
Yeah, perfect. Yeah, we'll go head over to like the Nanoblock side of our CNC collectibles. So let's go check it out.
So AJ, here we are at your Nanoblock section, which is very popular. What toys do you guys happen to have?
Yes, so here at Nanoblock, we've got all kinds. We've ranged from video game characters like, we got Kirby, right? Kirby. And Pokemon. Right, and then we've got like some other stuff like foods, animals. So from foods, we have one of my favorites is the ramen one, just because there's this noodle and it's like, looks like it's hanging, so it looks like it uses gravity, and I just love that about it. So we have a range from, again, video game characters, anime characters, pets, foods. In fact, we've got like a space set coming out later on this year. So if you like telescopes, spaceships, I think there's like an astronaut as well. It's to wait for. I saw the photos from, like, I want to build these. I can't wait for these. The telescope, especially for me.
Now, do you guys have the designers in-house, and then you guys all sort of meet and figure out what the next iteration will be?
So, Kawada, we work closely with, actually, the designers for it. So, our brand manager talks to them, you know, and then we meet up with them as well. And we just kind of go through the rounds with it, thinking. In fact, there's, like, this really beautiful piece we have in our office. It's a Pac-Man one. It looks just like this, my shirt, but it's in nanoblock form. I'm like, oh, man, I wish I could show it. I want to show it off. So.
Have they made that yet?
We actually have a Pac-Man with the cherry and the arcade. So people who are like, oh, I remember having an arcade, going to the arcade playing Pac-Man.
Yes.
We have all sorts for that.
But you don't have that.
This
yet.
Specifically, no. But the fun part about, like, nanoblock is, you know, every brick, no matter how, like, these characters, even to the bigger ones, they use the same size brick. So all it takes is just imagination and just figuring out, like, the 3D aspect. And I love that. It's like, man, I have to think about it. So I had already said to someone, like, man, kids who are playing with nanoblock now, they'll be great at 3D design in the future. They're going to be engineers at this point.
Oh,
they'll be
God.
Designing the future stuff.
That is so cool. I wish I could think like that, because I love toys like that. But when I was a kid, little girls didn't really play with block type things, but now it feels like a lot of game makers and toy makers realize there's no girl boy toys. There's just toys and imagination.
Exactly. And I love it because it doesn't matter whether, you know, you're young, old, kid, boy, girl. Like, for the nanoblock, it's for everyone. Like, the difficulty, there are different difficulties, and that's fine. You know, we like them, you know, these ones have a very good entry level point, but we've got, like, ships, right? And, like, I had told someone, we have a Titanic ship. And it's, like, pretty large, but the difficulty for that, it's higher in difficulty, but I always say, you know, it's about patience, so you just build, like, 5 minutes here, 10 minutes maybe there another day, but in the end, you'll get it done, so I never say it's too difficult, just the amount of patience you have for it, and all of them are available, like, at shop.bandai.com, so we have a whole plethora of, like, items available, things you see here, and there's some other stuff that's not here that's available online.
Those bigger ones sound like almost like a holiday fun activity when everybody gets together of all ages.
Yeah, in fact, we have, like, holiday sets that come around. Like, we had, like, a Christmas one. We had a wreath, a Christmas tree. There's, like, a snowman. So, you know, for the holidays, you know, the company for Nanoblock loves to be festive as well.
I'm really curious. Do you guys have some that you guys experimented with, decided not to sell, and then people get to keep them at their desks?
I'm sure they have done that in the past, because, you know, like I said, it's an engineering thing, so I'm sure someone had this idea, put it together. In fact, like, during shows, we have, like, this whole thing where people get to play with the nanoblock, and someone made, like, Mario and Luigi, and we're like, wow, this is so cool. So rather than breaking it apart, or someone breaking it apart, we just displayed them, like, on top of this, like, a shelf right here, just to show off, and it was, like, one of, like, our highlights, because the imagination for it was... No, further than mine.
That is beyond my imagination. Yeah. But maybe I'll get some nanoblocks and try it out. Now, which ones do you have that are part of your own personal collection?
Oh, so I do own the ramen one myself. I do have one of the dogs. I think it's a Shiba one over there.
Oh,
and
nice. Do you have a Shiba?
I don't, but I out of the dogs, I'm like, this is cool. I like this. I do want to build all of them, though. Like, that's the fun part is, like, once you start, you're like, all right, to the next one. And it's my favorite one. I think, like, so, like, I do love the Pokemon line a lot. So my favorite is, like, Bulbasaur. But I do like how the bigger ones are. So, like, the Blastoise looks really good. And same with the Charizard. I think there's a Snorlax. It's perfect. It's round and it looks hefty. And so that is my favorite one on there.
Now, do you guys have any upcoming collections with Nanoblock that you can tell me about?
Yeah, so we do have, like I said, we have the space set coming out later this year. That one's going to be, I think, around, like, August or so. Don't quote me on that. But, you know, if you follow us at Nanoblock US, we have all tons of information. We even have, like, larger Pokemon's ones coming out. So we'll have, like, a Rayquaza. That one's got, like, joints to move and everything like that. So be on the lookout for new Pokemon and new space sets.
Gotta find them all.
Yeah, gotta find them all.
So let's look at the other side and tell me which items do you have in your collection from the other side. Because I love you guys. You guys have so many fun, different items that really fire up imagination, not just of children, but adults. And more importantly, the price point is affordable.
Oh, of course. In fact, if we go check out just a little bit further down, we've got great trading figures that are perfect for, like, almost anyone.
let's go check them out.
All right.
So, show me what you got, AJ.
All right, so right here we've got the Tamashii Nations World Tour. Now, this is an event that's going to be taking place in April in New York, and these are the exclusives that are going to be available at that event, and like only at that event. So for people who really love Tamashii Nations and all our action figures and love exclusives, this is one of those you can't miss.
Is it a limited edition exclusive?
Yeah, so all of them have different packaging. Mm-hmm. They have, actually, in fact, it makes it kind of difficult because now you're like, do I take it out of the box? Do I play with it?
That means you buy two.
Yeah, oh, you know what? You're right. Two is the way to go. One to keep, one to open.
Yes. Oh my gosh, so let's get a little bit closer.
Yeah. So, all right. So I'm going to talk a little bit about these. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different exclusives ranging from Dragon Ball to Gundam to Saint Seiya, Macross, and even Spider-Man. In fact, the Spider-Man and Spider-Gwen have exclusive bases for themselves for this event. They're all regular release, but the base that you see here currently is not the same one. So this one is specifically for that event. And they'll be released a little bit earlier than the normal one. So that's kind of cool for collectors who kind of want to get the figure ahead of time.
So I have to ask about this event coming up in New York. Are there tickets available? How does it work exactly? And where can they go if there are tickets to be able to attend and purchase?
Actually, this is just going to be open to public. You can come by. It's going to be at Grand Central Terminal. So if you're in New York, you know, head on down there. We also have something at Duffy Square where you can take photos as well. So it's more for the public to enjoy. So
it's not a con, it's something you guys are putting out.
Yeah, it's just an event that we're putting for Tamashii Nations to celebrate. And it's going to be fun. I can't wait for it.
So do you have any of these in your particular collection?
Actually, so I used to have this Goku. But this is a newer version of it. It's a lot shinier with the hair. But that was the only one. Most of these are gonna be like brand new for the con itself. I'm actually looking forward to the Spider-Man itself. Like, I cannot wait for both of these. These are gonna be like my first, like as soon as like we get a chance to, you know, set up everything and everyone gets their stuff, I'm gonna like hold one of each for myself.
Well, I have to ask, will you guys be making special t-shirts for the employees? Because it seems like you guys have special employee t-shirts here for WonderCon.
That I don't know. I'm sure we'd want a way to distinguish between staff and fan, but we'll have to wait and see and find out, because then I'll be rocking one of them.
Oh my gosh, this is so cool. I love these collections. I love the nano boxes, and these prices are totally affordable for the average as well as passion fan.
Yeah, exactly. So, like, for some of these, you know, we have, like, this Gundam one's about 50, and then we have, for Saint Seiya fans, this 125 may seem like a lot, but the fact that usually this stuff gets harder to find as time goes on, I'm willing to pay that. So, yeah, it's affordable in my eyes.
And so it would come with the stand and then the stand for the flames.
Yeah, so this one will have like this little effect for it, as well as a figure. We do have a promo for this special Tamashii event. I believe the details for that will be released a little bit later.
And so if anyone wants to find out more details, they can follow you guys on Twitter, Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, and on your website. How will they find you all?
So one is, if you follow us at Bandit Collect, that's the whole range of everything that we do. Also, there's also Tamashii Nations on Twitter, and Instamashii on Instagram. So, you know, with that, it'll tell you all the details as well. But I suggest following us at Bandit Collect, because we love to talk about that stuff. We get really excited, and we'll share all the info there.
Well, I'm excited. This is such a fun interview talking to you, AJ. And I have to say, even while we were talking, the fans were listening to see what tidbits you were sharing. And I know once I post this, everybody will be really excited and we'll try and make plans to head to New York for April 28th to 30th to attend the Tamashii Nations World Tour, because those collectible items look a lot of fun. And I think it's a geek-worthy trip.
Yeah, there's going to be tons of displays. You're going to just need your photo camera ready for all the photos.
And you'll need either cash or your credit card. This is Sherry at WonderCon. I'm talking to AJ, and I think I'm joining the Tamashii Nation.
Welcome aboard.